الكفر ينقسم إلى قسمين.
Disbelief is of two types.
كفر إعراض وكفر معارضة. كفر إعراض بأن لا يدخل في الدين لكن لا يتعرض للدين بالسب والشتم كما حصل من أبي طالب.
So disbelief is of two types. The first type of disbelief is كفر الإعراض, meaning a person just turns away from the religion. So a person insults the religion, opposes the religion, go against the religion, but he just turns away from it, meaning he chooses not to believe, like the action of Abu Talib, the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
الثاني كفر معارضة, يعارض ويقف ضد الإسلام ويحارب ويسب ويشتم ويستهزئ ويسخر كما حصل من أئمة الكفر أبو جهل مثلا. نعم.
And the second form of disbelief is كفر المعارضة, meaning a person who stubbornly rejects, insults, mocks the religion of Allah, like that which occurred from the leaders of disbelief, such as Abu Jahl.
هذا الذي يستهزئ بالكتاب أو بالسنة أو يسب الرب أو يسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أو أحد من الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام. نعم.
So this person who makes mockery of Allah or his messenger, or he insults the religion or the Lord or the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam,
أو بآيات الله الكونية أو الشرعية,
or a person who makes mockery of the signs of Allah, whether these signs are physical and universal or whether these are signs of Islam, i.e. in the Quran,
فهو كافر كفر أكبر, نسأل الله السلام العافية.
So this type of person is a disbeliever with the major form of disbelief, and we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
وكفر هذا,
and the disbelief of this person,
كفر معارضة مثل ما حصل من أبو لهب وأبو جهل. نعم, لأنه يسب ويستهزئ. كيف يسب ويستهزئ ويسخر بأحق الحق؟ قل أبي الله, يعني ما بقي أن تسخر وتستهزئ وتلعب إلا بالله وآياته ورسوله. نعم.
So this person, the one who mocks something from the religion or insults the religion or Allah or his messenger, mocks the messenger, his kufr, his disbelief is the kufr of mu'arada, the kufr of insulting and mocking and insulting Allah. Why? And this is the most severe form of disbelief. Why? Because this person is mocking the most truthful of truths. Like Allah said in the Quran, قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ, say that at Allah and his ayat, his verses, and his messenger used to mock at.
يعني ما بقي لكم, أي من كان يوجه لهم هذا الخطاب, ما بقي لهم إلا أن يلعبوا بالكتاب وبالسنة وتكلموا في الأنبياء والرسل عليهم الصلاة والسلام وفي رب العزة.
Meaning, those people who mocked Allah and His Messenger, those people who addressed in this ayah, was there nothing else left for them that they could mock? Was there nothing else left that they could mock except that they had to mock Allah and His verses and His Messenger?
هذه المسألة مسألة مهمة جدا.
So this issue is a very, very important issue.
لأن هناك من يمزح.
Because some people, there exist some people who joke.
ويأتي أحيانا حتى بأمور حتى يضحك بها الناس من الكتاب والسنة.
This matter is very, very important, very, very dangerous, because some people, they use things from the Quran and from the Sunnah in order to make people laugh.
فإذا كانت المسألة واضحة بينة.
So if the issue is clear and apparent,
سب للرب,
for example, a person insults the Lord Allah,
أو للنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام,
or a person insults the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام,
أو بآيات الله سبحانه وتعالى,
or a person insults the verses of Allah,
فهذه مسألة واضحة جدا.
So then this issue, this ruling is clear and apparent.
فهذا كافر كفر أكبر مخرج من الملة.
This person has disbelieved with a major form of disbelief and he's left the fold of Islam.
وإذا تكلم إنسان,
but if a person talks
بشيء أو ذكر حديث وضحك الناس,
but But if a person he says a hadith in order to make people laugh,
ننبه هذا ونحذره أن هذا استهزاء وكفر.
Then we have to warn this person, and we have to guide this person. We say to him that look, this is mockery and this is disbelief.
فإن
so if
رجع
if this person repents and returns,
تركنا.
Then we leave him alone.
وإن أصر على اللعب بنصوص الكتاب والسنة والاستهزاء كفرنا.
If, however, this person continues and persists upon making a joke of the ayat of the Quran and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then this person is considered as a disbeliever.
من العجب.
From the strange things.
لا تسمع أحد من أهل الكتاب.
That you never find a person from the people of the book.
يسب الرب.
Ever insulting the Lord Allah.
أو يسب أحد من أنبياء أهل الكتاب موسى أو عيسى عليهم الصلاة والسلام.
Or you never find anyone from amongst the people of the book ever insulting the prophets of the Jews or the Christians, meaning موسى عليه السلام وعيسى عليه السلام.
مع أننا نعرف ما هم عليه من يعني ترك الدين وغير هذا.
Even though we know what they are upon in terms of leaving the religion.
لكن تجد.
But you find.
وإلى الله المشتكى.
And to Allah is the complaint.
من يدعي أنه من أهل الإسلام.
You find a person who claims to be from the people of Islam.
ويسب الرب.
And yet he insults the Lord Allah.
عيانا جهارا ليلا نهارا.
He insults him specifically, insults him in the open in front of everybody.
بل عندما سب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من بعض الناس في بعض الدول الكافرة.
Rather when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was mocked and insulted in some of the countries of disbelief.
خرج بعض الناس في مظاهرات.
Some people they came out in demonstrations, demonstrating.
دفاعا عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
Defending or in defense of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
المظاهرات لا تمت للإسلام بالصلاة كما قال هذا الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله تعالى. يعني ليس لها علاقة بالإسلام المظاهرات.
So these demonstrations, as Sheikh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah mentioned, they have no relationship to Islam.
الشاهد.
The point is.
أن هؤلاء خرجوا في مظاهرات للدفاع عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
That those people they came out in demonstration for the defense of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وكان فيهم.
And amongst them was.
من يسب الرب.
A person who insults the Lord.
وخرج في مظاهرات ضد من يسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And yet this person, he comes out demonstrating against those people who insult the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
من أولى بالإنكار؟
Who is the one who is more appropriate of being forbidden or spoken against?
أولى هذا لأنه هذا يدعي الإسلام.
The first person who should be spoken against is this person because he claims for himself Islam.
ثم بعض الناس يدافع عن هؤلاء.
And then some people they defend those people.
ويقول أن هذا عندما يغضب يسب.
And they say that these Muslims who insult, or they came to be Muslims and they insult Allah, that they're only doing this when they become very angry.
طيب لماذا عندما يغضب لا يسب والده مثلا؟
So why is it that when this person becomes angry, why doesn't he insult his own father?
أو لا يسب الرئيس.
Or he doesn't insult the leader or the ruler.
والله لا يتجرأ أن يسب أقل فرد من أفراد هذا الرئيس ولو كان جندي صغير لأنه يخاف من السجن. أما في سب الرب يسب
said, by
ولا
Allah,
يبالي.
By Allah, the lowest level of soldier, the lowest rank of soldier, he doesn't have the courage and he doesn't dare to insult his ruler. Why? Because he's scared of the punishment of being imprisoned. And yet, when it comes to insulting Allah, then they do this and they don't care.
إذن
and therefore
لابد أن نكون على ما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And therefore we have to be upon what Allah سبحانه وتعالى said.
إنما المؤمنون الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت أي خافت قلوبهم.
We have to be upon the example that which Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, that indeed the believers, they are only those people when they are reminded of Allah, وجلت قلوبهم. Their hearts tremble with fear.
وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا.
And when the verses or the ayat of Allah are read or recited to them, then their iman it increases.
ولابد من الإنكار على كل من يحدث منه شيء من هذا سب للرب أو للدين أو للنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And we have to speak against and forbid every single person who insults Allah or the Messenger or the religion.
لأن الذي يسمع السب
because the one who hears the insulting
إما أن ينكر أو ينصرف
either he should forbid and speak against it or move away.
إذا بقي وجلس
as for if he remains and he sits
ولم ينكر
and he didn't forbid this action
فهو مثل السب
then he is similar to the one who is insulting.
والدليل قول الله تعالى
and the evidence of this is the saying of Allah the Most High
وقد نزل عليكم في الكتاب
indeed he has revealed upon you in the book
أن إذا سمعتم آيات الله
that if you hear the verses of Allah the آيات of Allah
يكفر بها
being disbelieved in
ويستهزأ بها
or being mocked made a mockery of
فلا تقعدوا معهم
then do not sit with them
حتى يخوضوا في حديث غيره
except that they start talking about something else
إنكم إذا مثلهم
if meaning if you do not do this then you are similar to them
أهل الكفر
the people of disbelief
أرادوا
they wanted
إيقاع أهل الإسلام في هذا
the people of disbelief they wanted for the Muslims to fall into this
صنعوا تمثليات
so for example they made تمثليات cartoons or models
يسميها هؤلاء تمثليات إسلامية
and they call them these people they call them like Islamic cartoons or
وهي في الحقيقة
and yet in reality they are
فيها تمثيل الكفر
and yet in reality these type of things they have in them examples of disbelief
يأتي في هذه التمثيليات من يمثل دور إبليس
so in these type of cartoons or these type of programs or these dramas where they depict Islam or the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم there comes somebody who acts as if he's Iblis
وأبو جهل
and somebody who acts as if he is Abu Jahl
وأبو لهب
and somebody who comes and he acts as if he is Abu Lahab an actor acting the role of Abu Lahab
في هذه التمثيليات
in these type of cartoons or dramas
يسب الرب
and then because he's playing the role of Iblis or Abu Lahab Abu Jahl he insults Allah
والدين
and the religion
والنبي عليه الصلاة والسلام
and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم
والحلف باللات والعزة
And also he takes a vow or an oath by the false deities such as Allat wal-Uzza.
وإذا أنكرت على هؤلاء قالوا هذا تمثيل.
And yet if you forbid those people and if you speak against those people they say look these are only dramas or cartoons.
النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام قال ثلاث جدهن جد وهزلهن جد.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said three matters when you are serious about them it's taken seriously and even when you jest about them or when you do these actions lightly or you are not in not being serious then they're still serious
يعني لا فرق في هذا الباب بين الجاد والهازل
meaning that these three matters there's no difference between the one who does them and he does it in seriousness or out of jest or doing it lightly
يسخر ويستهزئ بسب الرب
a person mocks and insults Allah the Lord
وبعض الناس يقول
and some people they say
نحن لا ندري أن هذا كفر.
We don't know whether this is disbelief.
سبحان الله. إذا ماذا يدري من الدين؟ إذا لا يعلم أن سب الرب كفر، وسب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كفر، وسب الدين كفر. إذا ماذا يدري من الدين؟ هذا معلوم من الدين بالضرورة. إذا كان قلنا اليهود والنصارى يعرفوا هذا، نعم، ولا يصنعوا أصلاً.
So he said, سبحان الله, glory be to Allah. If this person doesn't know that this is disbelief. If this person doesn't know that insulting Allah and insulting the Messenger and insulting the religion is disbelief, then what does he know to be as disbelief? If the Jews and Christians, as we have said, if they know that insulting their Lord or their religion or their Prophet is disbelief, then how is it that this third person doesn't know? Rather, this matter is an issue which is known by default, out of necessity.
Inshallah al-afiyah wa-salam.
And we ask Allah for safety and pardoning.
Na'am. Thumma qal.
And then after this, the author, rahimullah, he said, السابق, the seventh thing, the seventh matter which takes the person out of all of Islam is as-sihr, magic. And included in this are ways of turning a person away from something he loves or swaying a person to love something through magic.